Kia ora everybody, my name's Nathan from the New Zealand Mountain Safety Council.
And I'm Tom from the Mountain Safety Council.
And we're out here in the Copeland Valley in South Westland filming season 2 of the Tramping video series. We thought we'd take some time while we're at Welcome Flat Hut to talk to you about distress beacons. It's a topic that has lots of questions on social media, so we're going to take a couple of minutes and run you through some of the basics.
So the first thing that we should talk about before we get into these devices is the fact that a cell phone in places like this is not going to cut it. You're not going to have any reception. It's just not going to do the trick if you're in trouble. And so that's why you need a device like this in the first place, if you're going to be outside of cell phone reception.
So the first device we're going to go through is a personal locator beacon, or commonly known as a PLB. Some of the pros with a PLB is that they have really good battery life. They can be quite small and compact and really lightweight. You can hire or buy a personal locator beacon, so you've got a couple of options. If you're buying a personal locator beacon, then it's really important you register the device, and you can do that at beacons.org.nz. When you're hiring one, you obviously don't need to do that. That's taken care of for you.
One of the other benefits of these is that if you're buying one, once you buy it, you own it, and there's no further costs for ownership, which is not the case for satellite messengers, but we'll get into that shortly.
Yep, that's right, Tom. So a personal locator beacon works on a different satellite network compared to a satellite messenger device. The beacons have a stronger signal, so when you set one off, it actually is picked up by the Rescue Coordination Centre New Zealand, which is in Lower Hutt, faster than a satellite messenger device. Because they have a stronger frequency, they're better off in some situations, in some environments, in terms of getting that message out to the satellite network. But one of the downsides with a device like this is that it really only works in an emergency situation. There's no ability to have any two-way communication. So you can't send a message saying everything's okay, we're at our destination, or you can't say, things are going okay, but we're held up. It's really only useful when you're in an emergency situation and you need to get help. They're really good in the sense that they have a homing beacon in them. So when search and rescue are coming to look for you, they can really pinpoint in on your precise location. So there are some pros and cons that you need to consider. We get lots of questions around the different models. What's the best model? Ultimately, they all have their different variations, but you just want to consider price, size, length of battery. So have a think about those things when you're shopping around and going to a store and talk to a pro about it. I think that's it on PL beacons there, Tom, so we'll hand it over for the satellite messenger device.
Yeah, so satellite messenger devices are commonly being used as an alternative to a PLB these days, but there are some real key differences that it's really important you understand if you're going to be making that choice. There's a number of different models in the market. They've become really popular in the last sort of 5-ish years or so. For this trip that we're on today, we've got a spot messenger, and our primary device is a Garmin inReach Mini. So basically the main purpose of a satellite messenger is that it offers two-way communication. So not only are you able to send messages away, but you're able to get some back. They also have an SOS function in most cases, though it is not as strong and it is not as fast generally as a personal locator beacon is. When you send off that SOS notification with a satellite messenger, that actually needs to go to an international sort of processing center, if you will, that then sends it to Rescue Coordination Center New Zealand. It's not a direct line, so there will be a bit of a delay in terms of them getting that. As mentioned, because it runs on a GPS network, a different satellite network, sometimes they'll have a little bit of a harder time getting your exact location correct, particularly if you're in a sort of confined valley environment like we're in right now. But yeah, those key benefits being, as mentioned before, with a PLB, you can really only use it in an emergency. With these messengers, you can use it for a lot of other purposes, such as saying, hey, we're at the hut, we're all good, everything's going according to plan, or hey, everything's totally fine, but we're just a bit delayed, so you don't need to stress. These are really useful functions with these devices that you simply don't have with a PLB. So some of the sort of key benefits on that side. Price-wise, a lot of them are pretty similar price to a PLB, maybe slightly less. However, most of them will require that you have a subscription service, subscription to use their features, which in the long run might make them more expensive than a PLB. Battery life-wise, a PLB only uses the battery when you use it. Whereas a inReach device is going to, or other satellite messenger is going to use it whenever you're messaging. So usually you want to make sure they're charged before you leave home, whereas the PLB is charged as long as you don't use it.
So I think the key thing, Tom, is that, you know, whether you're going out tramping, hunting, climbing, whatever you might be doing, just consider your situation, your circumstances, eh? Have a think about the different environments you're heading into, and there is no one device that's perfect in every situation. There are pros and cons, as we've talked about. I personally kind of like carrying two devices, particularly on longer trips or trips that are a bit more, you know, challenging.
Yeah, and for the purposes of what we're doing here with our filming, it's really great because we're able to send a message to our families and our co-workers every day saying that we're all good. Or if, you know, we need to get a helicopter transfer for one of our trips, we can message the helicopter company as well with us, which is kind of cool.
And if there was an emergency,
that's what we would use.
We'd pull out the PLB and set it off. So hopefully that's been helpful. Like I say, head into your local outdoor store and chat with the pros, or send us a message on social media and we can answer any more technical questions you've got.
Thanks, guys.
Cheers.